Honorable Myron V. Walwin, Minister for Education and Culture. Mr. Trevor Grant, Chairman of the Virgin Islands Festival and Fairs Committee. Mr. Ricardo Richardson, representative from CCT Boat Phone, our gold sponsor. Platinum sponsor. We got that. Mrs. Janice Blyden. Invited guests, and of course, the media, a very pleasant good morning. At this time, we will go right into our festival press conference, as we've been waiting. We'll go right into and welcome to the podium Mr. Trevor Grant, our chairman, to tell us what 2017 festival will be all about. Welcome him, please.
The protocol has already been established very well. Thank you so much, Brenda. Good morning once again to everybody. I'm very happy to see so many of you here. As usual, it gives me a great pleasure to be here on behalf of the Virgin Islands Festival and Fairs Committee. I'm the chairperson, and the members of the Virgin Islands Festival and Fairs Committee are very happy to be once again putting on festival for this year, 2017. It's our 63rd annual festival. So, festival for me is a very special time. I mean, we get together, we have the opportunity to share culture, we have the opportunity to share food, we have the opportunity to share our music with friends and visitors alike. And it's just one of the times of year that we're very proud as a people, and it's one of the times of year that I love the most. But it gives us a chance also to reflect on, you know, how far that we've come, being emancipated from slavery, and how much further we have to go, actually, as a community, once we stick together, because of course, there's many nationalities here that, in the BVI, and if we stick together as a community, we can get together much, much farther. So I'd like everyone to support all the festival activities that we're going to be putting on for 2017. Support the parade, regardless of how big or small it may be, and support all of the events leading up to Festival 2017, please. We have a team of very hardworking volunteers on the VIFFC and all the subcommittees that I want to thank already. I also want to thank the persons from the Ministry of Education and Culture, all the staff from the Ministry of Culture as well that have some of in our presence today, and for the hard work that they do leading up to the festival, because without them it would not be possible. So, as usual, this year's Emancipation Celebrations are going to take place from Sunday, the 30th of July, to Saturday, the 12th of August. The official opening ceremony is going to take place on Monday, the 31st of July. It's going to be preceded by the annual torchlight procession. And then the opening ceremony of the village we're going to have on the Monday night. That's going to be our cultural night. And this will be very pleasing, I'm sure, to the person who the village was, Rotan Village is named after, Mr. Neil Blyden. I'd like to give us a moment of silence in remembrance of Mr. Neil Blyden, please. Thank you. And of course, we have Mr. Blyden's beautiful wife here today. We're going to hear a couple words from her. Janice, thank you for coming. The East End Village will then run from Tuesday, the 8th of August, to Wednesday, the 9th of August. Then on to Carrot Bay Cultural Fiesta on Thursday, the 10th of August, to Friday, the 11th of August. We're very pleased to announce that we have once again signed platinum sponsorship. And I want you to give a big round of applause to CCT. CCT is one of the businesses that put their money where their mouth is when it comes to supporting local. And we thank you so much for coming on board as a platinum sponsor. and also as a silver sponsor, I want you to put your hands together for the National Bank of the Virgin Islands. Thank you. Forming these partnerships make putting on festival a lot easier on the government's purse, so I have to say a huge thank you to the platinum sponsor CCT, the silver sponsor National Bank of the Virgin Islands, and there are more sponsors that are also interested in coming on board, so I thank you in advance. Each year, the VIFFC decides on a well-deserving person for each village to honor during the celebrations. We also solicit the participation of our community by hosting a competition for the festival theme and slogan. And the theme and slogan really sets the tone for festival, and it's used in the festival publishing, pageantry, calypso renditions, and it presents a colorful hue for August Monday. Thank you for August Monday Parade. So, once again, I'm very pleased to announce the 2017 2017 combined theme and slogan. And the combined winning theme and slogan was submitted by Kayasha Matavius and Tiana Hewitt, who were both here, and we're going to be presenting them with their checks that they've worked so hard for. And the combined theme and slogan is "A colorful kaleidoscope to be seen, creating a cultural scene for Festival 2017. Give them a round of applause, please. I'd like to thank them for their submissions, and I'd like to thank all the persons that submitted. We had one of the highest trafficked presentations, so people putting in to win the theme and competition this year, so we're very happy that we could get that. So this launch also is going to be highlighting our headliners. I am not going to be doing that. We have respective persons that are going to be doing that. I will be doing it for the Eastern Langluk Committee because I have to give apologies for Ms. Sandra Warakan. She is the head of the Eastern Langluk Subcommittee, and she can't make it this morning. She sends her apologies, so I'll be revealing the lineup artists. And I just want to say that the lineup artists, that the headliners that we have, you know, they're really here to just augment the festival. We try to make sure that we have a good mix of entertainers. I think we've done that. And, you know, it's just for us to make sure that we remember where we come from and to enjoy our festival. Thank you very much.
Now, it gives me great pleasure to welcome to the podium the one who gives us the money to do what we need to do.
Yes.
The one who pushes us to do better and better every year as we celebrate our culture. I would like us all to welcome Honorable Myron V. Walwin to the podium. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Madam Chairperson. As the appropriate recognitions were made already, it should be sufficient to say good morning. Good morning as well to the members of the media. Welcome to the official launch of Festival 2017. The Virgin Islands will commemorate 63 years of emancipation celebrations under the theme, "A Colorful Kaleidoscope to be Seen, Creating a Cultural Scene for Festival 2017. I would also like to join and thank Ms. Keisha Mactavius and Ms. Tiana Hewitt for their winning selections. For the past years, our themes and slogans have shown the link between this celebration and our culture, because culture is an integral part of our emancipation celebrations. It reiterates that we cannot forget our practices and ways of life that have identified us as a unique people. It is no secret that festival celebrations mean different things to different people. For some, it may mean the enjoyment of a long holiday and one full of merriment. Others may observe the true meaning of the celebrations by recounting the lives of our forefathers, their struggles, and their fight for freedom, which is the true meaning of our celebrations here in the territory of the Virgin Islands. For persons like the chairman and members of the Virgin Islands Festival and Fairs Committee, it's a time when some of the toughest backbreaking work is done to ensure the staging of our national festival. Please give the members of the Festival and Fairs Committee and all the volunteers a round of applause for me, please. The organization of our festival is not at all an easy task. It is a mammoth one, saddled to those whose hearts often swell with national pride as they work to make the celebrations a success. On occasions like these, we remember the efforts of many great Virgin Islanders, like the late Noel Harrigan and Mrs. Esme Downing, Mrs. Margaret Board and Mr. Carl Dawson, Mr. Ishmael Scatliff and Mrs. Eileen Parsons, just to name a few, who were the foundation of our festivities. It is well known that the road to festival may oftentimes be stormy, but in true spirit, it takes on a life of its own, and when it happens, it is always one for the history books. This year's festival honoree is well-fitting. He was no stranger to the emancipation celebrations, probably involved in every aspect of the festival, from devoting his time on several committees to village production to media production. The late Mr. Neil Mellie-Blyden is well deserving of being honored for the 2017 Emancipation Celebrations. Mr. Mellie was instrumental in implementing what we know now as our international weekend in the Rowtown Village. He was a cultural patriot and used his media resources to promote local bands and their music leading up to and during our festivities. Mr. Mellie was a staple on the waterfront for the August Monday parade, where his ZVCR trailer was always visible. Since his death, I often wonder from time to time what August Monday would be like without Mr. Mellie being there. We thank Mrs. Janice Blyden for allowing us the opportunity to celebrate her late husband for Festival 2017. Give Ms. Blyden a round of applause again for being here. And on a somber moment, I want to encourage all of us that we should give people their flowers while they're alive. Just a thought for all of us. As we create a cultural scene for Festival 2017, I encourage our local groups, dancers, schools, and associations to partake in our annual August Monday parade. I've been receiving great feedback from the committee, and we anticipate that this year's parade will be a grand one. Several troops have already started to promote their costumes and partial routines on social media, creating a friendly competitive hype that has not been seen in many years. I encourage our interested persons to collect your forms at the Department of Culture and register today. Festival cannot happen without the involvement of the community. Festival has some great highlights this year, including the grand opportunity that our Miss BVI 2017 will experience. I am pleased that our executive committee and the Miss BVI subcommittee saw it fit to merge with the Miss World and Miss Universe franchises for the betterment of the pageant and overall experience of the crowned queen. I would like to thank very much Miss Alicia Hamm, chair of the Miss BVI committee and the Miss Universe franchise holder. And I would also like to thank Mr. Damian Grange, chair of the Miss World BVI franchise. They and their subcommittees have been working tirelessly to ensure that we have a successful pageant and reign of Miss BVI 2017. We anticipate that this relationship will elevate the roles and responsibilities and the status of Miss BVI as a territorial ambassador. It's important to recognize our platinum sponsor, CCT Global Communications, and our silver sponsor, the National Bank of the Virgin Islands, both of whom have been avid supporters of our festival activities over the years. We are truly excited to have our local companies invest in these celebrations annually. It says to me that they are committed to giving back and enhancing the local community. Their efforts and promotion of festival is an invaluable service that we owe a debt of gratitude to them for. Give the sponsors, please, a round of applause. As I said before, festival is hard work, and Festival 2017 would not be taking place without the hard work and dedication of the Virgin Islands Festival and Fairs Committee, headed by Mr. Trevor Grant. I also wish to thank the subcommittee chairs and the many volunteers who continue to work tirelessly to ensure that the celebrations are successful. Your commitment is truly appreciated. I think we're going to have a wonderful festivities this year, and I invite everyone to come out and enjoy with us. Thank you very much.
Well, you've heard it there. Come out and join us, because this year will be grand. I would like at this time to invite Mr. Ricardo Richardson, our platinum sponsor representative of CCT. Well, let's welcome Ricardo.
Good morning, all.
Good morning.
I would like to acknowledge the protocol already established. No. Having said that, I am a man of very few words, so I will be very brief. On June 8th, CCT proudly announced our official signing on as the Platinum Telecommunications Sponsor of the 2017 BVI Emancipation Festival. As the BVI's premier 4G LTE network, we jumped at the opportunity to once again sponsor as BVI culture advocates. CCT's sponsorship is inclusive of prizes for all of the various pageants and competition winners, including Miss British Virgin Islands, Prince and Princess, Mr. and Miss Junior BVI, Calypso and Soca Monarchs. And CCT will be also an official ticket outlet for all BVI Emancipation Festival events. So if you're looking to get a ticket, you know exactly where to go. We will also be out and about with our CCT Festival Friday promotions every Friday leading up to festival. So this Friday, look out for us at Village Key. We will be there from 4:30 to 4 o'clock, from 4 o'clock to 7:30 p.m. And there will be an appearance by the Miss BVI and the Mr. and Miss Junior BVI contestants. You can come out. You can win some amazing prizes. And leading up straight onto festival, we will be at some other locations such as Marche. We will also be at Myatt's at the Pier Park. And on the 28th, we're looking to wrap up everything with a big block party, well, a parking lot party in front of the CCT flagship store, which is also a band album launch for the OMG band, who is one of our ambassadors. CCT customers on social media are encouraged to join in the festivities by using their smartphones to post as many pictures as they can, and also use the hashtags CCT is we, BVI Festival 63, and FET Unlimited. I thank you.
At this time, we would like to honor our theme and slogan winners, and I invite the chairman once again to let us know the theme, a colorful kaleidoscope to be seen, creating a cultural scene for Festival 2017. I would like to invite Ms. Kayasha McTavius.
Kayasha, enclosed in this envelope is your check for $250 for a successful winning of the Human Slogan Competition. Thank you so much. Thank you.
And let's welcome Miss Tiana Hewitt.
Miss Hewitt, enclosing this envelope is your check of $250 for being successful in your Human Slogan submission. Thank you so much. We really appreciate it.
Wonderful. Job well done, ladies.
Actually, we have a word from Ms. Hewitt. She wants to say something.
I just want to say thank you for this opportunity. I was not aware of the contest until I looked in the Island Sun and I figured out that I can actually enter the contest. And I was really surprised that when I won, I was ecstatic. I could not believe that I actually won a contest because I don't really enter contests. And I just want to say thank you for the opportunity and thank you for a chance to show you guys my skills and my talent, because I knew that I wasn't really a dancer, so I couldn't join a trooper festival. So I had to find something else to execute my talents. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Good morning.
Good morning.
I would first like to thank God for giving me the knowledge and inspiration to submit my entries. Thanks to the members of the BVI Festival and Fairs Committee for choosing my submission for the team for Festival 2017. Thanks to my sisters, aunts, mothers, Janice Nibbs Blyden and Mrs. Eileen Parsons, who supported me. To the memory of my late godfather, Mr. Neil Blyden, I thank you. Your words of inspiration in helping me to aspire, sorry you have gone too soon. This one is for you, as your memories will live on. Thanks to all, and have a safe and happy festival, as it will be a colorful kaleidoscope to be seen, creating a cultural scene for Festival 2017.
Thank you.
Thank you very much for those moving words, which takes us right into welcoming the lovely wife, the one and only, Mrs. Janice Blyden, to give remarks on behalf of her late husband, Mr. Neil Blyden. Let's welcome her.
Morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I am honored to be able to stand here in place of my husband, Mr. Neil Blyden. In the library, we always say that a picture is worth a thousand words. And while I was going through his belongings, I found some pictures of him and his involvement in festival. And I thought I wanted to share one specifically with you, one showing him and his ZVCR girls at the Eastern Festival 2004. And here we have Neil at his best. I think those who remember him, right, will recognize him in this way. He liked to put on, you know, designer clothes. He liked to stand there at festival. He liked to make sure that everyone had a great time for festival. I met him when he came home in 1989, and Mr. Wheatley invited him to join the festival committee. And he always felt, you know, that it was a time for celebration. If you look at this picture, but his thing was to have everybody happy for festival. You understand? And I remember when he said to me, he said, I'm going to create a pageant. I'm going to create an event that is going to have everybody. And it's going to have to be on the recreation ground because nowhere else is going to be big enough to host it. And he said, I am going to have artists from all over so that everybody can welcome. And he created the International Calypso Night. And it was like, you know, a time when, who puts a reggae artist on a thing with a calypso artist? And he would do those type of things, you know, he would put in the different elements in there that made you want to come. I remember the year he said, I'm going to bring an Indian artist because the Indian community never have anything to celebrate for festival. We always have things for us, but their culture is a little different. So he brought an Indian artist, and I remember standing in the village, and when this gentleman came on, I saw Indians rushing through the gate, right? It's like, it was such a moment for them. And you know something else I noted when I stood in the village was to see that as each culture was represented on stage, right, people would just move back. And the people for that culture would go towards the front of the stage. They would have their flags and they would be waving. And, you know, it was like that artist saw his people there, you know, in celebration of him. So it was, you know, Neil was that type of person. He loved festival. He loved the excitement of creating events that would make people want to enjoy themselves. And I am honored to be here this morning to say, you know, thank you to those of you who wanted to let his legacy live on. I'm hoping that this festival will definitely be something that he will be proud of, you know, something that he would have had a part in. We want an exceptional international night where we have artists from all over the Caribbean. I hope they bring mine from Dominica, because I'm hoping that everybody will enjoy themselves and have a great time and celebrate this festival in his honor. Thank you.
Thank you very, very much, Janice. At this time, we'll move forward. I think this is the part you've been waiting for, the reveal of the artists. We will start with the reveal of the artists in Rote Town, and we will invite Mr. Kenny Thompson to help us with that. Mr. Thompson.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Mrs. Blyden, I have to find an artist from Dominica. So I guess I have to go back to the drawing board to find that artist from Dominica. I don't know if you have a particular one in mind, but you give me a task. So, Mr. Minister, we need some more money. We'll start with the international acts. I know we've been waiting for all this time. And as usual, you know, we have dubbed the Friday night as International Reggae Night. So on that night, we're going to have the So Strong family, Ras Aimo, Drastic, Pressure, Revelation, Taurus Riley, and we're adding others as we go along. And Saturday, which is basically like a mix. Back in the past, when Mr. Millis started it, it was International Calypso. But it like you said, you know, he brought a reggae and soca. He mixed them together. So we continued with the fusion. So on a Saturday night, we're going to have Roy Cape All-Stars featuring Blacks, Rupee, Tizzy, and she's from Antigua. Rupee is from Barbados. And we're going to have Orlando Octave. He's from Trinidad. And we're going to have B-More, Money, Rock City, and we're adding more. Have to find a Dominica artist. We're still building on the individual nights during the week. So as we go along, you're going to get a lineup as to what local and regional acts are going to be on those nights. All right, thank you.
Okay. Moving right along, we're going to go to the east. And as said before, the chairman will reveal the artist for the Eastern Long Look Festival.
Thank you, Brenda. I'd like to also mention that, of course, we try to do things a little differently every year to change things up. And on Sunday, the 6th of August in the village, we're going to have a very first Latin night. And Mr. Kenny Thompson is going to be looking for art, has secured, I think, two artists for the Latin night on Sunday, August the 6th. In addition, we have joined forces with the Soca Monarch competition. The Soca Monarch competition is now going to be held in the village on the Thursday, August 3rd. So we're very happy to have that now featured in the village as well. So, moving on to East End, Tuesday, August 8th, the headliners for the East End Long Look Festival Village are Linky First, Sanchez, Bungie Garland and Fayan Lions, and Rock City. That's for Tuesday. Moving on to Wednesday, I'm pleased to also let you know that the world famous Rise and Shine will remain on Wednesday in Eastern Long Look. So the artists for the Eastern Long Look Rise and Shine, we're actually having two trucks for the Rise and Shine in Eastern, and we're gonna have BDJ on one of the trucks, and on the second truck we're gonna have a USVI BVI collaboration. And also, on that same truck with the USBVI collaboration, we're going to have Asa Banton of Dominica. So, get ready. That Wednesday night, the international acts are going to be Cool Session, and we're going to have the village closing out with Destra. Of course, there will be local bands featured at each of the villages. So they're going to be a part of our festivities as well. So that is the East End Long Look lineup. Thank you.
Chairman, and to round it all off, we head to the West, when we're going to learn about the reveal of artists in Carrot Bay. Please welcome Judy.
This year, the Carrot Bay Cultural Fiesta commences on Thursday, 10th August, and the Fisherman's Tournament will be named in, we will be honoring Mr. Oliver Turnbull. Oliver is a young fisherman. He actually is a young man who has been fishing from in his early teens. He has a hearing impaired. He is hearing impaired from early 13 or 14 years of age. On the Thursday, we will kick off with the Fisherman's Tournament, which will, the fishermen will go out around 5 a.m. and come back for weigh-in at 4 p.m. During the evening, our activities will officially open, and we will have the entertainment by local bands, and we will have Triple K out of Dominica. So there you go, Ms. Blyden, you have your Dominica band. Stiley out of St. Croix, and our top headliner is out of Miami, Florida, T-Vice, which is a Haitian, they have Haitian background. So they will be here for the first time in the BVI. On Friday the 11th, we will have our usual cultural races, which commences from mid-afternoon. And during the evening, we will have entertainment by Patrice Roberts out of Trinidad. And a few more acts, but we'll not be revealing them at this time. Bringing down the curtain will be our very own Vibe, who has for the past months been our ambassadors in the U.S. Virgin Islands. Up to last night, they had a great crowd that followed them to St. Thomas, and we expect the same thing done at Carrot Bay, in St. John, sorry. During the 2017 activities, there will be entertainment for the whole family. So we take this opportunity to invite everyone to come out and celebrate with Rotown, Easton, Carrot Bay, and then to bring the curtains down again at the Rotown Festival Ground. Thank you.
Okay, there you've had it all, but I need to reiterate that this year festival will end in Rotown on the Saturday. So after all the festivities in Carrot Bay, we come back east, and Saturday night is the big grand round off in Rotown. I would like to thank everyone for coming out, the media. You've heard all the plans for Festival 2017. We ask that you encourage everyone to come out, join us as we celebrate our culture in a safe and healthy way. I thank you.